Good. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about responsible artificial intelligence. What is it and why should we care about responsibility when we develop and use AI? So we should start by asking, what is AI? It's not just about the algorithms. It's not just about machine learning. AI is not magic, but AI is also not just simply the next step in automation. So we really need to look at it from the perspective of understanding and realizing that these type of systems are increasingly autonomous, so they are able to take steps and take actions without direct interaction with people. But they are interacting with us at the same time. They are acting in our world, they are making decisions for us, and they are using resources and affecting our environment, our societies and our lives. And at the same time, because of the type of technology that we use, they are adapting and they are learning, like we hear all the time, to new knowledge, to new information, to new data. Still, these are pieces of software. They are just like any other piece of software, something that someone built to a certain purpose and to according to a certain type of instructions. So it is not magic. It is very clearly a tool that we can use. And it's up to us to use it as best as possible to us and to our societies. Because these systems are not alone. They are part of a larger social technical system, a system in which people and organizations and institutions all participate. So this, the software in itself is only one piece of this big system. AI is also not intelligent, at least it's not intelligent in the way that we think people are intelligent. Yes, we can do a lot of very smart things with AI. Yes, AI is increasingly quicker and increasingly better at doing a lot of identifying patterns, finding new data, finding new insights. But still, it is extremely easy to trick AI. And these are just examples, and there is an increasingly larger field of science in which people are trying to find the limits of AI. And it's easy to trick it. It's easy to find some situations in which the system is completely out of its scope, and therefore it starts making errors. And maybe the ones we see here are not the most interesting, but when we realize that AI can easily be tricked into changing its understanding of the what is sensing in the environment, like in the example below, then we really need to start asking who is responsible when, and how are we going to make decisions based in this type of systems. Because AI can identify patterns, but it has no idea about the meaning of those patterns. It cannot identify school buses or stop signs or cats or dogs or cancer cells, but it still will not know what does that mean and what is it or not. So we really need to be responsible ourselves for the ways that we are using AI. Because AI can potentially do a lot. Our question and our first question should AI be doing it? And then who are we that are taking that decisions? And which values should be considered? Whose values should be considered? And how can we deal with all the dilemmas around the different opinions, different possibilities, different interpretation of these values? And how can we prioritize them? Are we going for efficiency or speed? Or are we going for fairness and safety? And what happens when we cannot have all at the same time? That's the essential question that we need to take when we are considering a responsible development and use of AI. Should we be using AI here for this type of situation? And again, like I say, who should be asking this question, and who should be answering this question? It's not something which can be left only to the engineers, to the ones who have programmed the systems. It needs to be a much broader answer to this type of issues. Because when we talk about responsible AI, it's not only recognizing that these systems, like I say, are tools, are artifacts, that we are the ones who are setting the purpose for these systems, and therefore we are responsible for the purpose. And it's also understanding that AI should be aligned, AI systems, the AI use, the AI development should be aligned with laws, should be ethical in the sense that it should be aligned with our own values, human rights and societal principles, but it also should be reliable. We should be able to trust that the system works as it say that it works. We should be able to trust that the system doesn't go into very strange types of decisions outside of that scope in which it has been trained for. It should be beneficial, and the question is again, beneficial for who and beneficial how. But above all, we should be able to verify and to guarantee that all these properties are there and are met by the systems that we use. And that doesn't mean that all of us have to become AI engineers, that all of us have to be able to wield this type of systems. But we need the guarantees, and again, these guarantees don't come only from the technology, but it comes also from the institutions and the organizations that can tell us, yes, we checked it when we have looked at it, people who understand the type of systems have looked at it, and you can trust that the system works as it's expected, and you also can trust that there will be guarantees and ways to deal with the few cases in which the system might go wrong, because of course, like any other thing, things might go wrong. We should think about which decisions should AI be making. Do we want AI systems to decide for us where we go, what we do, what are our goals? Should AI be taking into account what is best for society, for all of us? Or should AI be taking into account what is good for me individually, for each of us individually? And what happens when these two things are not aligned? What happens when we cannot have it all? How should AI decide between freedom and security, between justice and privacy? Those are not questions that can be left to a piece of software. These are the questions that we as societies need to discuss before we start using systems that replace us in parts of these decisions. Because what is socially accepted or morally, ethically acceptable or legally allowed are not always aligned. And it's up to us as societies to ensure that we create the best possible interactions or responses for this type of systems. There are a lot of issues when we talk about AI and ethics, when we talk about AI and responsibility. And no, it's not only about the trolley problems or the decision that self-driving cars should take when it needs to cause some damage. It's about, for instance, ensuring that users of chatbots understand they are talking with a machine and not with a person. Is understanding that this type of chatbots, this type of systems which are meant to support you in your decisions, to support you in your development, are potentially manipulating the emotions of people, are potentially, and in many cases intentionally, trying to change the behavior of someone to help you walk more or quit smoking or all kinds of things. But it's an interaction with our own power of decision, our own capacity for agency, for our own ability to take decisions. So we really have to understand what we are doing with this type of systems. It's also about understanding that we are the ones who are accountable. It's not about saying computer says no, or sorry, the computer is not is saying something or another. No, we have to have the institutions that can take the accountability for whatever the system is doing. It's understanding that the data that we use for this type of systems, and yes, most of these systems are based on data that has been collected and developed around identifying patterns on that data. It's understanding that the data is about the past. It's understanding that the data, in many cases, have been collected for other types of purposes than the one we are using it now. And therefore, that this data, because comes from us, from people, from our own decisions, the data will necessarily be biased, be skewed, be incomplete, be messy. And therefore, we have to understand what it means to take decisions based on this type of data from the past. How can we use it to take decisions about our future? Which decisions should the system take? And like I said again, how can we balance between all the different types of properties, of values? How do we balance between privacy of the individual and security of the group? How do we balance between the accuracy, making the system better, more and more precise in its answers, but which means more computer power, more energy, and how we balance that with a sustainable world and aims for sustainability? It's about understanding who is taking responsibility. And the responsibility never lays with the AI system. The AI system is a piece of software. It's also understanding that all of these values, all of these principles are necessarily interpreted by us and are necessarily interpreted differently in different cultures, by different people, in different situations. It's easy to say we want systems to be fair. It's much more difficult to define what we mean by fairness. And even more difficult is that we all agree that on a specific definition or interpretation of fairness. How can we agree and how, who is going to decide? And then we can build this type of systems. So in order to take responsibility, we have to understand first that, like I said, the AI systems is not alone. And this social technical system around the system, so us, the ones who use, the ones who decide about using, the ones who develop, the ones who are affected by the system, the ones who are able to govern it or to direct or to make the policies around the use of these systems, we are the ones who are taking the responsibility. And if the system is autonomous, then we need to be able to define where is the responsibility for the actions of the system. If the system is interacting with users, with people, with our environment, we need to be accountable for what the system is doing. And if the system is adapting, then we need to have some level of transparency, of openness about what and how this adaptation is happening. And all these properties are not necessarily only about the software that we are using, are mostly about the organizations and the people around this type of systems. Unfortunately, there is a lot of work being done that at many, many different levels from the European Union, where I participated last year on the definition of the principles for responsible AI, which are there in that green circle to the right. But many other organizations, from small companies to large international organizations. At this moment, I believe that there are around 150 or more this type of principles and guidelines. There are two things here. One is that the principles and guidelines are not for the software. The principles and guidelines are principles for us, for the people, the ones who decide to develop and who use this type of systems. And moreover, like, it's easy to come up with the guidelines, is easy, or at least it's possible to come up with the principles and guidelines. It's possible to define this type of requirements. It's much harder to move from this type of requirements to some concrete actions and concrete implementations. It's possible, and it has been done, and many of them, most of these systems say that we want systems to be transparent, to be fair, to take care of bias, to take care of diversity, to take care of well-being. It's much more complex to move and to implement and take action in this type of issues. And that's where we really now, all of us, need to move forward and do. And that doesn't mean that all of us have to become software engineers, AI developers, data analysts. We all use the roads, we all use the traffic, but not all of us are car mechanics. We really need to be able to trust the ones which understand. We also need to trust the ones who set the policies and set the regulations and set the certifications for this type of systems, that the system indeed does what it's supposed to be doing, and that there are settings around which guarantee that if, in for whatever reason, the system is not doing what is expected to do, that we know how can we address this type of problems. In the same way that we don't really, looking at these eggs, we don't know whether they are or not free-range eggs or organic eggs. But we trust the agencies that check and that evaluate the eggs to tell us what should we use, what should we buy when we go to the supermarket. So we really need to take this certification, this support for the users approach to AI. And I just want to finish with these concerns, which are very, very central at this moment, as AI is being used more and more in many different types of situations. Still, diversity in the development and use of AI systems is very far from what we would want to have, not only in terms of gender diversity, but especially in terms of ethnic diversity, and especially also in terms of discipline diversity. We can, all these type of questions that I have talked in the last few minutes are not questions who can be answered only by engineers. We really need to take a multidisciplinary approach to AI. And at the same time, we really have to be aware and change the type of priorities that are around when people are defining and designing and implementing this type of systems. It's not only about the speed of the system, it's not only about the accuracy of the answers, but it's also and foremost ensuring that the systems are helping us reducing bias and providing us enough transparency about how the system is used. And I think I finish here. Thank you very much. What is important to realize, I think, is that AI can give us a lot of answers, but we really need to start understanding which are the questions we want AI systems to give us. Thank you.